Hello everyone, Dan here, back for another Thoughts video, and today we're talking about the LEGO Avengers Endgame sets. They're finally revealed after a while now, so let's get to talking about them. Okay, so the smallest set is Captain America Outrider Motorcycle set, and yeah, like, can you believe it? LEGO is doing another Captain America set with Outriders. And this is also, like, what, the third Captain America motorcycle in a row? Though the motorcycle itself looks alright, though, it seems pretty oversized, if you ask me. It's definitely pretty big, but I do like the blue coloring, I suppose, and the shooting disc feature is kind of neat. And I guess the Outriders are Wolverine now. But definitely best part of this set is the new Captain America minifigure, though I wish we'd gotten a stealth suit, but I understand why they put him in a Quantum Realm suit, or whatever suit that is. But it's also really nice, the new removable helmet that you can have for him. Really reminds me of Michael MGF Captain America minifigures, and be interesting to try that helmet around with other Captain America LEGO figures. And also, as some people point out, also, it looks like he even has a new shield now, too, where it's red, white, and blue on gray, so that's kind of nice. But yeah, I suppose for a smaller set, it's alright. But I do prefer the Outrider Dropship Attack from last year, definitely over this. I still need to get myself some more of those. And then next we got the Hulk Buster, War Machine Hulk Buster, and it looks really awesome. And then I know this was technically revealed already, but I thought I'd just talk about all these sets all in a row. I did surprisingly enjoy the Hulk Buster from last year, and I really am thinking maybe I should one day get the 2015 version, that way you can have all three versions. Well, I also need to get the UCS one, but yeah, War Machine Hulkbuster. Never thought of that, but it looks super cool, and he even got the things that scream War Machine, like his gunneries and whatnot, like his missiles and machine guns, and it looks actually surprisingly really cool mounted up there. Like, the Buster itself just looks really awesome. It looks like it would be really cool to play around with. And we got some Outriders, again. And of course, the real figure to talk about in this set is, of course, Ant-Man, with finally a new accurate helmet. It does look like he's obviously using the new Firefly helmet. But I do actually like the way it looks. The other helmet had, like more visor to it, which is also a little bit more accurate. So it would have been nice if they maybe at least could have added a visor to that. But it still looks pretty good and definitely more accurate looking. But yeah, this War Machine Buster definitely looks awesome. I would be looking forward to getting it, and definitely be interesting to compare it to the previous ones. Then we got the other big Avengers Endgame set, which was revealed a while ago as well, which was the new big Avengers Quinjet set, and I think this might be like our fourth LEGO Avengers Quinjet if you count the Captain Marvel one. Basically love Quinjets now, but this one still looks really nice. I definitely love the navy blue coloring on it, and they're using a lot of Nectonites pieces there, so it almost looks like a combination of Avengers and Nectonite ship. And I'm definitely hoping there's an interior in there, because it looks like you could open it up and play around there, so that'd be really cool. It actually still looks really cool. It almost looks like an oversized Civil War one, but I do love the coloring and the builds of the Quinjet, and it definitely does look really structurally sound. It was a random term I just then used. And the figures, looks like it's just mostly a bunch of Avengers and Quantum Realm suits, and we got Hawkeye, even though I wish we could have gotten Ronin. A lot of missing minifigures here, guys, but. And we finally got some updated Chitauri figures, and they definitely look more accurate looking than the 2012 versions, that's for sure. Then this random Avengers car four-wheeler thing. I'm assuming it's just there so you can roll it out of the back of the Quinjet, kind of like some others. Which, suppose for that, it serves its purpose. And LEGO coming back with the teal brick separators. Nice, nice. I really hope that LEGO would come out with more multiple colored brick separators. But yeah, and this thing is also over 800 pieces, so this might possibly be one of our biggest Quinjets yet. But correct me if I'm wrong in that. But yeah, I wonder how big this thing is going to be in real life. It's probably going to be pretty big. And we got the two sets I was really looking forward to back when I heard the description leaks. And of course, the first one is going to be, of course, the Iron Man Hall of Armor. And it definitely looks really kind of cool. And like, we finally have a Mark 1 and Suitcase Iron Man 2 armor. And those two look really great. I'm also excited about these suits, because this also means now that if you think about it, we now actually have an Iron Man suit from each movie that Iron Man features in. Then you also got the Igor suit, which looks a little rough if you compare it to a side picture, but yeah, the design, that could have been a little better, but I don't know. I see LEGO had to use up all their Outrider figures here. The little landing pad for Iron Man, and looks like you can even get him suited up. And little computer chair, which I think I heard has Jarvis on there, and Agent Coulson. And a random blender, so Tony Stark can make himself a smoothie. And little dummy robot thing over there. And he also got Tony Stark's wig. Yeah, that definitely looks like this could be a really cool set for if you ever find it on sale, you can get multiple copies of it, make one big armor room set, and you can put some of your other Iron Man suits in there from previous Marvel sets. That would actually be really dope. My only problem with this set, and I said this in my thoughts, some of my thoughts videos before, and I'll say it again, the price. Like, it sounds like apparently this is supposedly going to be $60 US. $60? I don't know, it just kind of feels like this would have been better at 40 or $50. So definitely looking forward to the set, but I probably am gonna wait for it to for that price to lower a little bit. And then we got the other set, which I was really looking forward to, which was the big Avengers compound battle. Which I was really looking forward to this set because I was really hoping they would make a new compound battle set since they made Avengers Tower back in the day. But of course now obviously the Avengers have a new base which they moved into in Spider-Man Homecoming. So I was really hoping they'd make a set of this, and they did. And it looks really good, even though I kind of wish it was a little bigger. But it still seems a little bit small for a building. Like, kind of wish they could have added a few more pieces to that. But especially for a $100 set, I kind of feel like it should have been a bigger building. You got a little garage back there for an Avengers vehicle and a helicopter, and even and it does have a helicopter pad over there. And the interior looks not bad either, where you can even have like a little conference room for the Avengers. Now to some complaints. Like I know I really complained about some about the build, but definitely when it comes to this set, the build is definitely better than the figures. Like those figures there, like just another random outrider. Like I guess Thanos is running out of armies here. And Thanos, just recycled that same mold again. Lego must be really proud of that mold. Like seriously, like couldn't you just give us a bald head figure? So you couldn't have just give us a finally accurate Thanos figure, of course. Then again, he could be wearing the helmet more in Endgame. We don't know. Still, just I think it would have been cool to get a bald-headed Thanos figure. I mean, supposed there is the problem of molds, but come on, they could have just easily reused the Darkseid mold from the D one of DC sets and to make a bald Thanos. So come on. And then Hulk doesn't look, he doesn't look bad. Like it's nice to have a little more smile Hulk, but it looks like according to the artwork there on the side, he's supposed to have wear some kind of quantum suit. So it would have been nice to have for him to wear a quantum suit, but no, it's just the same old shirtless Hulk. And then you just got the same old Captain Marvel figure, so you'd be getting doubles of that figure if you got the Captain Marvel set. And the Iron Man is just the same Iron Man figure, but with gold arms. And then of course, then there's also missed opportunities of figures. Like, come on, you could have thrown like a stealth suit Captain America figure in there, or Ronin, or something. Like, there's so many many figure missed opportunities here. Okay, I'll move on from my complaints. But yeah, it's definitely the figures could have been way better with this set. So while this set definitely has problems, I definitely probably will still get it. Even though this may be a netter pricey one at $100. I mean, I guess that's probably because of the two big figs, but And those are all the Avengers Endgame sets. I'm surprised there's only five sets though this time around instead of six like last time. But yeah, I do definitely think some of these sets do have problems, like the prices and some of the figures could have been a little better, and then also the main figure missed opportunities. But yeah, they do have their problems, but I do still think they're pretty good. I definitely will be looking forward to collecting all these sets like I did last year with the Avengers Infinity War sets. But yeah, those are my thoughts on LEGO Avengers Endgame sets, and let me know in the comments down below, guys, what do you guys think of these sets, and what is your favorite and least favorites of the wave? Let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, give a like, and be sure to subscribe if you want to see more videos, and I'll see you next time. Avengers Assemble! Yeah, Cap better say that in the movie.